Let's talk about the Layers feature in HID Remapper. If you've used a keyboard firmware like QMK before, you probably already know what it is. It lets you have two or more sets of mappings that you can switch between. It's very handy when your keyboard doesn't have enough keys for all the functions you need. Let's see what it looks like in HID Remapper. And by the way, HID Remapper is a universal adapter for USB input devices. With it, you can do things like remap keys on your keyboard, or make some of the keys work as a mouse, and a lot of other cool things. And it does it all in hardware. You don't have to install any software on your computer. Here I have the keyboard plugged into HID Remapper, and HID Remapper itself is plugged into my computer. As I said, layers let us assign another set of functions to some keys. Let's make it so that the WASD keys function as the arrow keys when the caps lock key is held. Let's go to the configuration website for HID Remapper. This is how you configure HID Remapper. Again, you don't have to install any software on your computer, you just go to this website in your browser. Let's make four mappings, one for each of the WASD keys. Let's set their inputs to WASD. And let's set their outputs to up arrow, left arrow, down arrow, and right arrow. The mappings tell HID Remapper to translate the input to the output. If we left it like this, it would permanently change the function of the WASD keys, making them work as the arrow keys instead. Which could maybe be useful in some situations, but it's not what we set out to do. Let's use layers to make it so that these mappings are only applied when the caps lock key is held. First, let's change them so that they're only active on layer 1. And then let's add another mapping that will activate layer 1 when the caps lock key is held. Set the input to caps lock and set the output to layer 1. And that is it. This configuration will make it so that the caps lock key activates layer 1 and that on layer 1 the WASD keys work as the arrow keys. Let's test it. Let's save the configuration to our HID Remapper. First let's connect to it. Okay, save the configuration by clicking Save to Device. And let's go to a keyboard testing website. When I press the WASD keys without pressing the caps lock key, they just work normally. But when I hold the caps lock key and then while holding it press the WASD keys, they now work as the arrow keys. Success! What about all the other keys? They still work the same, regardless of whether we're pressing caps lock or not. This is because, by default, HID Remapper passes through all inputs unmodified, if they're not specifically mapped to something else. If you don't want that, if you only want the mappings you specifically created and want all the other keys to just do nothing, then you can configure it here, in the Settings tab. Unmapped inputs pass through on layer 0, 1, 2, 3. You can set it on a per layer basis. For example, if I uncheck this for layer 1, save the configuration, and go back to the keyboard testing website, then all the keys work when I'm not holding caps lock, but when I hold caps lock, only the WASD keys work because we created mappings for them. When a null layer is explicitly activated, in our case when the caps lock key is not held, then layer 0 is active. And because we have the pass-through flag enabled for layer 0, all the keys work normally. Okay, bonus round. I noticed that it's not convenient to have to hold caps lock while I want to use the WASD keys as the arrow keys. It would be nice if I could activate the layer by pressing caps lock once and then later deactivate it by pressing it again. As it turns out, it's very simple to do exactly that. All you have to do is enable the sticky flag on the mapping that activates layer 1. Here. Let's save this and try it now. First, let's see that the WASD keys still work normally. Then I press the caps lock key. I don't have to hold it. Layer 1 is now active until I press it again. The WASD keys now work as the arrow keys. And when I press caps lock again, layer 1 is no longer active. We're back on layer 0. And the WASD keys work again as WASD. Okay, and that is the layers feature in HID Remapper. To learn more, check out the project's GitHub repository. If you have any questions, please leave a comment. Thanks for watching.